Suppose that the instruction we fetch here is a jump instruction. Next cycle, this jump moves here. The problem is, we fetch this jump, but in this cycle here, we didn't even know what it is. So when it moves here, the next instruction we fetch will be the one that follows this jump in memory. So we will have, for example, a subtract that never should have been fetched, because we should have fetched from the location where the jump is going, but at this point where we needed to decide what to fetch, we didn't even know that it's a jump. Meanwhile, we are decoding the jump. So at the end of this cycle, we will know it's a jump, but we may not know where it's going. So now let's say that here we figure out this is a jump and where it's going. Meanwhile, our subtract has moved here. Something else has been fetched from the location where we shouldn't have been fetching things at all. And now we figure out that really we should be fetching from somewhere else. So what happens now is called a pipeline flush. What we do is we convert these fetched instructions into pipeline bubbles. And then as the jump moves on, these two bubbles will also move on. And now we will fetch the correct instruction that should have been fetched right after the jump. So as you can see, a jump in this case, because it caused the pipeline flush, has two bubbles that follow it, and only then we have the next instruction. So if we count for these two instructions what the CPI is, it's actually four cycles for only the two instructions. So as you can see, these pipeline flushes are going to be an additional source of having a CPI larger than one.